when he came into my studio, and I gave him some brushes and gave him some paint and said, "Here, Jeff, just take this and mess around, have some fun." And so that's what he did. And he loved it. So then he did another one, number two there.
That's number two.
Yeah, that's the second one he ever did.
So tell me about that.
Well, he, I felt that he could go in and paint by himself, so I never hovered around him or anything, and he was always like that. He never really asked for any help, which was amazing, and I just gave him the paints and the canvas and the brushes, and eventually he did different styles, different techniques, and
all on his own without
teaching. That's what was amazing. I mean, we had lots of art in the house, and there none of the art in the house, he never painted any colors or anything that showed that art influenced him. So I don't know where he got his ideas from.
That's an exceptional picture.
Yeah, it is. It's small too. Okay.
So this is one. It looks almost like a gorilla with his face kind of cocked. Tell me about this one.
Well, that was when Jeff started using a sponge more than the brushes, and he liked mixing the paint with a sponge. It was a sea sponge. It had different. I have to see if I can find one around here. He used acrylics, and he had a palette, and he would, you know, squeeze out the colors that he wanted, and maybe a couple of colors, maybe four or five, and he would stick to a relatively few number of colors.
Well, now this is one of a series of three
landscape-oriented
pictures.
Yes.
So what about that one?
Well, I found that, and I don't remember him painting that. He was pretty much left to his own devices. So, and if I was working on something, then we pretty much didn't interfere or bother each other. So a lot of times he did things and that I missed.
Yeah.
Yes, I remember that because it started off, if you look at the bottom, as one of the styles that he would do the whole painting with that sort of look, and then he put in the yellow sky, so he was trying to be, you know, paint somewhat realistically. So this one, if you look at the trees and the bottom part of the painting, you can see the style of one of his paintings that is all over the painting, and then he came in and did a sky and a background, so when he made those trees. Because of the color and the pattern, the color was very different than his usual palette. And he did a couple that are really bold and bright.
Do these things reflect his mood?
I usually when he painted, he was in a good mood, or he would become, you know, get in a good mood after he painted some. So I think maybe he liked colors so much that he was trying different colors and to see what that would do. I mean, that's the thing now that I think about it. So I just finding these things that I had found. I wasn't even that aware of them. Well, actually, that is, he used metallic paint on those areas. And that was one of the styles that I found that he, you know, did these big spaces and, I have to think of a better way to describe that technique.
Well, you know, it almost looks like maybe he was watching MASH and he got inspired by camouflage.
Oh, I don't know. Actually, look, there's a face and, huh. Well, if you look at that, it's you see mostly the yellow. I have to check the color. I don't think the blue pops out as much, but
as it should.
Well.
Oh, you mean this picture makes it look a little more stark than.
Yeah. The yellow, the eggs pop out more. And the snails and the, it just looks like fun, like he had fun painting that. So just, you know, he put those things on there, and that looks like an eye. It's sort of a smiling, I mean, you can look at things and you see just the color and the shapes and everything. Then other times you can look at it and it's, there's an eye and there's a mouth, and so this is when he was using the sponge, and I love how he could put in these brighter colors, because he really didn't have that much control over his movements, and yet this, the way it was done, and when I've tried to duplicate using a sponge and some of the colors, and actually it's very hard.